Hello everyone, this is financial author Amit Dhan of amitdhan.com. On this channel, you'll find financial, travel and more videos just like the one you're watching right now. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing. Air Canada departs Aeroplan and three things you must know. Hello everyone, this is Amit Dhan of amitdhan.com. Today, I'll talk about three things you must know before Air Canada and Aeroplan terminate their contract and take two separate paths. I'm expecting this video about 3-4 minutes long. The first thing you need to know, the date when Air Canada terminates its contract with EMEA, which is the parent company of Aeroplan. This date is June 30th, 2020. The second thing you need to know, you're not going to lose your Aeroplan points after June 30th, 2020. Your points will remain the same and the points are not going to go anywhere. However, what you're losing is the access to Air Canada flights and Star Alliance flights. And in number three, I'll mention why it is so important. The third thing, which is the most important thing, you need to know that after June 30th, 2020, you'll not be able to redeem Aeroplan points for flight redemptions, especially Air Canada and Star Alliance flights. Star Alliance is the world's largest alliance and it has airlines such as Air Canada, Singapore Airlines, Thai Airlines, Turkish Airlines, Lufthansa and many other airlines, totaling 28 of them. And because Air Canada is part of the Star Alliance program, right now or in the past, Aeroplan gave you access to redeem points or miles for any of these flights, especially for business class flights. Once Air Canada departs Aeroplan, you'll lose that privilege and you'll not be able to redeem flights for any airlines. What it means that you'll be able to redeem your Aeroplan points for gifts or other merchandises, but it will not be able to give you value for your points. Let me just give you an example. I'll be traveling to Asia in November and I redeemed 75,000 Aeroplan points flying business class from Toronto to Dhaka, and at the time I purchased the fare, the original cost of that flight was $5,000. So what it means that my 75,000 points generated me 7 cents per return or 7 cents per point return, which is not bad. The reason I'm saying this is not bad because I have had situation where I redeemed my points or miles for business class flights where I received 35 cents per point return. So 7 cents per point return is not that bad, but it's not that great like 35 cents either. However, once Aeroplan is not a part of any alliance or Air Canada, you don't have that option to redeem these points for any flights, especially for business class flights. So the best thing you can do, you should redeem your Aeroplan points before the termination date, which is in 2020, June 30th. Because after this date, you will not be able to redeem points for flights or any Star Alliance flights. Now, be careful about redeeming your Aeroplan points for Star Alliance members flights because some of these members charge hefty fuel surcharges and some of them don't. I have a video about this which I'll provide a link in the description box below. So before you do anything, just think of redeeming your flights or your Aeroplan points to get the most out of it. So in that way, you'll have a better value for each hard-earned point you have been collecting for so long. That's all for today. If you like what you see, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing, and there'll be more video coming up. Thank you.